professional footballers. A moment in time. Manchester City, FA Cup winners.
Eltham, SE9. Home to Cray Valley Paper Mills FC. The club started life as a works team in 1919. These days, the Millers ply their trade in the 8th tier and are in the first round of the cup for only the second time. Just up the road, less than 3 miles as the crow flies, is the Royal Borough of Greenwich's only EFL club, Charlton Athletic. Now in League One, the Addicts had a notable 7 straight years in the Premier League.
And the valley has erupted.
They've torn it up in the FA Cup and all.
A 1-0 victory gives the cup to Charlton Athletic.
After more than a century living side by side, today these neighbours meet at last as Eltham's finest roll up the A2 to the valley for the FA Cup's first ever Greenwich Borough Derby. Could a South London upset be on the cards?
Good evening, welcome to the Valley for a London derby like no other. It is Charlton Athletic of League One against non-league Cray Valley Paper Mills in the FA Cup first round. So a very good evening to you. Welcome to the Valley. It's going to be a fantastic first round match this evening. And delighted to say I'm joined by a Charlton Athletic legend in Paul Konchesky and a legend in Joby McEnough. Good evening, gents. Very good to see you. Look, there's a big distance in quality between these two sides, but very, very close when it comes to where the clubs are based. Could that be a shock tonight, Joby?
Listen, I think you have to come if you're Cray Valley and really make sure that you get absolutely everything spot on. I was at Leighton Orient when we lost to a team that was 8th tier at the time, Maldon and Tiptree, so it definitely can happen. What needs to happen, obviously, is they have to be absolutely spot on, and you're hoping that maybe Charlton come and not quite at the level that they are week in, week out.
I love the fact you've still got fond memories of that tie.
Selective memory, I did try. Okay. This tie actually made me bring it all up again, Jason.
Paul, good evening to you, and the very fact that these clubs are so close together adds a bit of spice, doesn't it?
Yeah, massively. I think being 3 miles apart with something to play for next round of the FA Cup makes it a little bit extra spice. But with Cray bringing 10 times more than they normally have at home, I think that makes it even more spicier for tonight.
Yeah, fantastic. I watched you watching the boys warm up as well. Miss days like this?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the pitch is immaculate, a little bit of dew on it. Night games are always special, special nights. And I'm sure for Cray Valley, they'll come and really, really relish this opportunity.
Yeah, we're talking of Cray Valley Paper Mills. They are 117 places, of course, in the football pyramid below Charlton. It is a long way from League One to the Isthmian League South East Division. And it's a big day in the Lisby household. Kyrell is Cray Valley's top scorer. His dad Kevin used to play there as well. He's best known, of course, as a Charlton Athletic legend. And Liam McDevitt spoke to them.
Kev, Kyrell, good to see you.
Right, you good?
All good. Right. You okay?
No, you're really good.
Yeah, good. You must be looking forward to the weekend.
I'm excited, bro. I really am.
Throwing it back, what was it like being in the Lisby household and your dad's playing in the Premier League at the time?
Back then you don't really appreciate it, but obviously now looking back it's a privilege to have watched, you know, your dad play at that such a high level.
Inspirational?
Definitely. That's why I'm here trying to follow in the footsteps.
Sunday the 28th of September 2003, does that date mean anything to either of you?
No.
Was in the Dartrick.
Kev knows as well.
It was a massive achievement and something I've said to my boys all along, that you have to appreciate the hard work that goes into even being able to be on the pitch and in a Premiership game.
And a real special moment. Talk me through your debut for this club.
Yeah, I think I was 16 and we had a cup match and I came in for my dad at around 60th minute, so it was a special moment. Obviously playing senior football at 16, it was good, and obviously to come on for my dad as well was even better.
You must have been incredibly proud.
I was desperate to come off to give him as much minutes as possible, so that was quite a good day for us as well in the family.
First round of the FA Cup, it's almost every non-league club's dream to get a good draw. We saw the video of you reacting to the draw. Charlton, it must have been the one you wanted when you saw the teams in the pot.
I'm a Charlton through and through, from 16 to 28 years old, 29 years old at that club, and yeah, I'm going to be looking forward to just watching my son play rather than supporting the team.
Who knows what can happen in the FA Cup? Obviously we know Charlton's a good team in League One, and we're obviously in the 8th tier of football, but you never know what can happen.
Love that reaction from Kyrell when the draw was made. And of course, Paul, you played with Kevin here, didn't you?
I did, yeah, many moons ago now. But if he's anything like his dad, he's got a good future ahead of him.
Yeah, fantastic. And in Kyrell, they've got a goal scorer, haven't they, Cray Valley?
Yeah, absolutely. He's had a fantastic start to the season so far. 13 goals in total, 7 just alone in the FA Cup. He's scored in every round so far, and that's something you have to remember. They've already played 8 games before tonight, and because they've had such a good cup run, it's given that group of players confidence. You can see here, getting into good positions, gets up really well. I know how hard Kevin's worked with his boys to try and get them to a level, and it's not always been an easy road. Kyrell got released from Watford, so it's a great story for a lot of young players out there today that may have had a bit of disappointment on the way, but to keep persevering, and huge opportunity for him tonight, but also a real special day for the Lisby family.
And with the greatest respect to the camera operator in those opening rounds, the cameras have got a bit better tonight, haven't they?
Should be expecting a few better angles than that, yeah.
But also, what have you made of the changes that Michael Appleton has made? Because they've got a big game against Portsmouth next Saturday, of course, Paul.
Yeah, they have. I'm surprised he's made 11, I think he's made today. He's putting a lot of faith in his squad because, like we say, these games are they're not thick and fast to come, and in the FA Cup, anything can happen. So I'm surprised he's made 11 changes to the team. But they have got a strong bench as well.
Although Alfie May is on the bench, of course, the top scorer as well. But in terms of managers, when they do this as well, so many of them have come and stuck. Look at what happened to Swindon Town yesterday, battered by Aldershot Town, 7-4, Joby.
It is a risk, and I think particularly when it's the number that he's made today, it's going to be a team that isn't in a rhythm, haven't been playing as many games recently. He will say there's still experience in that team and should be able to get the job done, but I would always look at these games as going as strong as I can to start with. You need to really make sure that you're setting the tempo and setting the tone. For me, if I'm Cray Valley, I'm looking at that team saying, let's go and get after them.
Absolutely, they will fancy it. Okay, boys, for the moment, thank you very much indeed. Let's hear from the managers. They've been talking to Mark Scott.
Well, Michael, you said that you were going to make changes, and 11 of them.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, obviously, there's still a hell of a lot of experience in that group. I thought that might be one of the questions. There's about 1,600 appearances between this group that are starting today, so there's definitely enough experience and quality to make sure that we get the job done.
And you've said, haven't you, that you do want to go far in the Cups. You've done it in the EFL Trophy because it gives everyone minutes to play.
Yeah, it does, and this competition as a manager has been good for me as well. You know, I've got to the fourth round, the fifth round, the quarter-final when my day's at Blackburn, so a good cup run can do wonders for a football club. It can keep momentum, keep people in a really good spirit and good place, so that's what we want to do.
Some people will say this is a free hit for the club because you're playing a side so much higher up the pyramid, but having spoken to you before, I don't think that's the way that you're going to view it.
No, you don't. You want to come and win games of football, but we've got to be realistic. You know, where Charlton are and what they're trying to achieve, promotion into the Championship. We're trying to get promotion into the Isthmian Premier, so there's a big, big difference. And all we've got to do is make sure that we give a good account of ourselves. We've got a lot of following coming today, which is going to be fantastic for our players to see their family and friends in that crowd. And if they can give a good account of themselves, I'll be proud of them.
Yeah, absolutely. It is a local derby. The away end is looking fantastic. They're very noisy, the Cray Valley fans. And no doubt there will be a crossover of fans who support both clubs as well, Joe.
Yeah, absolutely, given how close they are in location-wise. And I think that will add to tonight. I think it will help the players as well, having that support here. And definitely something for them to really use to spur them on throughout the night.
What do you think is being said in that dressing room, Paul?
I think for Cray, it would be go out and enjoy yourself and do what you've done to get this far. For Charlton, I think it'll be, let's make sure we come in as winners and we need to get our hat in the next round.
And also, Joby, you know, you've been talking about Cray Valley's form in the FA Cup, how well they've done to get here. Often in sport, in football, we talk about being battle-hardened. Well, they are.
Yeah, absolutely. They're coming in good form. They score goals, which I think for them is huge tonight. They can keep it nice and tight and then take an opportunity when it comes. They have got players that can hurt Charlton.
We are all set. Sit back, relax and enjoy it in the company of Matty Upson and Mark Scott.
Thank you very much indeed, Jason. So it is Valley at the Valley as the Millers aim to scale a mountain in terms of the football pyramid. 5 leagues and 117 places separate the sides. Indeed, if it were to happen, it would be the biggest upset from an away team in the competition's history in terms of the league ladder. Quite a contrast geographically, just 2.5 miles as the crow flies between the clubs, so perhaps no surprise that this is one of the closest first round draws in FA Cup history. along with Everton against Liverpool and Nottingham Forest against Notts County. Always a big occasion when a club much lower down the food chain gets a draw away to a league side, but Cray Valley Paper Mills also are facing a former FA Cup winner to boot as well. Bingo, already one off the list. Michael Appleton in charge of Charlton Athletic. It's been a pretty decent start to his time at the Addicks helm as well. And Appleton said that he would make changes for this evening's match, and he has named a completely different 11 to the side that started the midweek win at Wigan. However, he points to the fact that there is still plenty of experience in the ranks. Amongst them is James Abakwa, who's on loan from Udinese and played a couple of games in Serie A last season. Caroy Anderson won his first caps for Jamaica last month, and Chem Campbell is on loan from Wolves. There's a Lisby in action at the Valley again. Kevin's 19-year-old son, Kirel, is arguably the star man in this Miller side. 13 goals in 17 games this season, 7 of them coming in the cup. Freddie Parker's no slouch up top either. 6 of his 11 have also come in this competition. Michael Ademolui completes the front line. He lost at this stage in 2021 with Bowers and Pitsy against Michael Appleton's Lincoln City. Plenty of respect between the two managers, and Steve McKibb taking in his second cup tie of the weekend, having been working as a pundit on Friday. Well, it is Remembrance Sunday next weekend, and before kick-off here, the Valley will pay its respects.
23, Corey Blackett Taylor. 25, Louis Watson. 32, Nathan Asimwe. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? Can I have your attention, please? Today, football remembers as we pay tribute to the fallen servicemen and women to whom we owe so much. We now ask everyone to unite and remember all of those who sacrificed their lives so that we may live and enjoy our freedom today. Through a period of silence, please join us for this period of silence, which will begin when our first bugler sounds his last posts and ends with our second bugler finishes, reveille. Please remain silent until the referee brings the silence to a close with their whistle. Thank you.
Thank you.
As mentioned, Kirrell Lisby is amongst the visiting side. We also have a Lee Byrne on the bench. And speaking of footballers who had their heyday in the 90s, Matt Upson's alongside me.
Thanks for the intro. Yeah, this is Tedic. He's going to be big this evening for Charlton. A lot of responsibility on his shoulders. Huge changes from them. And he's going to have to lead that line and put away some of the chances that you'd think Charlton are going to create.
Well, they have been full of goals this season, especially in the FA Cup. Cray Valley Paper Mills in amongst that group is Kirrell Lisby.
Well, what a big moment for him. I hope he's relaxed, I hope he's ready. I'm sure his dad's watching, but he's in good form this season. 13 goals, so he certainly knows where the back of the net is.
Ben Speedy is our referee this evening. And he's been on the end of a rant from Michael Appleton in the past, with the then Lincoln City manager having a go at him a couple of years ago when he thought Ipswich's winner should have been ruled out for a push. Just a reminder, and some of you will be happy about this, no VAR. So Charlton Athletic in the red shirts and white shorts and red socks will be kicking from right to left in this first half. So Cray Valley Paper Mills get their big night at the Valley. Not only are they up against EFL opposition, but also a former winner of the FA Cup, Charlton Athletic, triumphing in 1947. But it is a much changed Charlton side this evening, 11 in all from the league game at Wigan in the week. Bit of a gamble, Matt?
I think it's a big shout from Michael Appleton. Really big call. You know, it's the FA Cup, you're playing a local derby to some extent. I know there are a few rungs down the ladder, but you'd half expect to see maybe the spine of the team still remain and make those changes maybe after half time. But he's gone with a completely fresh approach, and we'll see how they cope.
Thomas forwards by Eden, and there's the skipper Arthur Lee. And there's a free kick for the Millers.
We've already seen Lee gobble up a couple of headers there. If Charlton want to play it long, I think that's something Cray Valley will probably cope with pretty well.
Now the skipper, who is at centre-half this evening, can also play on the left side. He was actually part of Steve McKing's promotion-winning Tunbridge Angels side and skippered Carshalton Athletic last season when McKim was also the boss there. Eden getting into a bit of a mess and then working his way out of it. Kirk sends it on. That's a useful pass. Taken a bit wide by Tedic. Still managed to get the ball in dangerously. And that's a really poor attempt by Anderson. A bank one. Roy Anderson. Here's Scott Fraser wearing the armband this evening. Eden looking for Fraser. No, did that come off last? Referee says goal kick.
That's a good sliding challenge from Tumkaya. Managed to just see the ball out. It was a real bit of quality a moment ago from Charlton, able just to manoeuvre the ball behind the Cray Valley back line.
Steve McKim doesn't have fond memories of the only previous occasion he reached the first round as a manager, with his Tonbridge Angels side thrashed 7-0 at home by League Two Bradford City 3 years ago. He'll be hoping that Cray Valley paper mills aren't shredded today.
Is that the first?
Might not be the last.
I hope so.
Adama Louie. Positive start from this much-changed Charlton, although I say that, and Kirk has coughed up possession. Adama Louie gone for goal and got a corner.
The first real test Charlton are going to have to face. Good piece of defending. Adama Louie gets the ball here. He scored a few this season himself. Decides to have a go.
Yeah, three this season for Adama Louie, two of them coming in the FA Cup. First corner of the game is for the non-league side. Barney Williams over it. And it's disappointing.
It is disappointing. They're the moments you win set pieces when you're the underdog. You want to try and put good quality into the box just to give your players a chance of a scrap almost, a ball dropping in the six-yard box, anything. You have to have good quality.
Ibrahim couldn't quite get there. Scott Fraser. That was ambitious from Chem Campbell, man who's on loan from Wolverhampton Wanderers. Asedu overran it, and that allowed Caroy Anderson to put in a thunderous challenge.
It was a good tackle, fully committed but fair.
Michael Appleton was appointed in early September, replacing Dean Holden, who actually became the first EFL manager to lose his job this season after a poor start to the campaign. He is the 22nd permanent managerial appointment at Charlton since Alan Kerbishley's stellar reign came to an end in 2006.
That's incredible, isn't it? I can't believe that. I mean, I remember playing here against Alan Kerbishley's sides. Wasn't that long ago? Mark?
Well,
there's a lot of managers in that time.
Fair to say that, having spoken to some Charlton fans, that they weren't necessarily over the moon at his appointment, but I think that he's won them over, both in terms of the results that have been garnered since he came in, and also the style of football. It's a lot more front foot, get the ball forwards quickly. It's not route one, it's just positive and aggressive.
That's very much Appleton's style.
Campbell showing a bit of style here, and fisted clear by Sam Freeman. First serious shot on goal of the game.
Yeah, you get the impression that Freeman's going to have a good game for Cray Valley if they're going to get anything out of this cup tie. Just opens up on the inside with his left foot. It's a comfortable save for the keeper down to his left-hand side.
Struggled to make an impact so far since joining on loan from Wolves, Campbell, but that was good, positive stuff. Oh, free header at the near post, and the Cray Valley Paper Mills fans enjoyed that.
Tough header to put goalwards. When you're that far in advance of the near post, you're kind of almost backpedaling a little bit. It's really difficult to get your neck around that.
Cray Valley Paper Mills average gate is 150. And they've sold around 2,000 tickets for today. Shem Campbell won't get there first. Lumped forwards by Asedu. Turned into a handy pass, in fact, for Lisby. More up than out by McCrandles. Competitive so far.
Yeah, ball's probably in the air a little bit too much for what Charlton would like. They want to try and get the ball on the floor, show that kind of golfing quality, start passing and moving.
And Steve McKim was actually kind enough to let me go down to training on Thursday night in Falconwood, and he said to me that he wasn't so worried about the technical aspect being massively superior, more the fitness and the physicality is an issue that he thinks will come to the fore.
Go, 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 go on.
Oh, firm but fair, according to the referee. Here's Thomas. A risky pass because Adam Alooy had read it and is aggrieved that he was seen to have committed an infringement.
I think it spun up and hit him on the hand there. The ball just flicked up in the air. Referee was in a good position to see it.
I'm not. You're a lot taller than me, and the gantry is not advantageous to those under 6 foot.
Do you want to stand on that chair?
Oh, ball through here. What a chance. And surely 1-0 Charlton. Scott Fraser on hand to give the League One side the lead and just dampen any early enthusiasm from Cray Valley Paper Mills. Clinical finish and perhaps the EFL quality showing there as he latched onto the ball and converted very calmly indeed.
And he takes that really smoothly, I have to say. It's a run from deep in midfield. He sees the gap, the distance between the centre-back and the right-back's just too much. And it's a very tight call for offside. Maybe the left-back just playing Fraser on, but it's a good touch past the goalkeeper, who has to come flying out off his line. Nice little over there from Tedic, isn't it? The awareness just to know the run's going in behind him.
And unlike the Premier League, no lengthy check to get the lines out. The goal stands.
I think the left back was playing him on. I think that Asadar was just about level or maybe half a yard playing Fraser on, but it was certainly very tight. You sound like you're missing seeing the lines. Is that what you want to see?
No, just pointing it out. I think it's refreshing. I think that most people revel in the fact that we don't have any stoppages for minutes while the lines are drawn.
Yeah, I agree.
But it's an uphill task for the Millers now, although they've got an opening here with Lisby. First touch really for Freddie Parker, who was aiming to bring Adam Alooy into it. Ibrahim. Vigor. McGrandles, Fraser, Anderson, it's generally been a 4-2-3-1 for Charlton Athletic this season. The Millers operate with a 4-3-3, that's the formation Steve McKing feels will get him the most joy in the league that they're playing in at the moment. Stresses that pace out wide can really hurt teams, but they haven't really been able to try and get the ball out to the flanks to use that to their advantage as of yet.
I mean, the midfield looks a little bit more compact today, understandably so, playing away from home at Charlton. I think just a little bit more protection for that back four.
Campbell. Now Anderson. Banquois has gifted that, though not great by Vigor. Eden. Cough that up cheaply. Here goes Vigor. Aiming for Lisby and just curling away from him.
Yeah, it's a shame he just couldn't put that ball in front of Lisby. It was a good run actually, he saw the space, and any little diagonal just clipped into the middle of the pitch. Could have been a dangerous ball.
It is the first ever competitive meeting between the clubs, although Charlton's Academy did beat the Millers 3-2 in an August friendly. I've been reliably informed, though, that was very, very early in pre-season. They weren't match fit at that stage. Sounds about right?
Yeah, I would say so. Wouldn't have had many minutes of pre-season at that point.
Kirk. Randall sent it on. Barney Williams. Parker was the target. And safety first from Thomas, who sent it out. Now he is a player that is full of goals. Enjoys quite a unique celebration as well. One of his FA Cup goals he toasted by having a sip of one of the supporters' pints.
It's a first, isn't it?
I thought you were going to say that you'd already been there.
Never seen that. He looks a physical presence, though, doesn't he? I think he'd probably hold the ball up well. It's just a case of getting enough of the ball in the right areas of the pitch for Cray Valley. Just having it wide, you'd think, just getting crosses into the box could be a threat for them.
Well, that is what they like to do. That's their style of play.
Yeah.
Good, pacey wingers who really like to take on their men, and then a physical presence in the box to try and pick out once they get to the byline.
I mean, they've got some serious goals across that front three, haven't they? I think maybe 27 combined between the front three this season, which is very good at this stage.
Lucas Ness. Abankwa back here for Ness. Thomas. Ness for Abankwa. Campbell's made the run. And he'll get to it too. Four in red in the area. Back for Abankwa. That's useful. Nicely met by Tumkaya. Not fully dealt with. In the end, it was slapped away by Lee. Almost got himself into a pickle there, Ibrahim. Conor McGrandles. Anderson. Vancouver's been a regular option out on that right. It's McGrandles for now. Infield by Kirk. Charlie Kirk. Fraser. Here's Eden. On from Caroy Anderson. Abankwa. Plenty of joy on that right-hand side for them so far, and anticipated well by the skipper Lee to get a boot to that. Anywhere will do for now for the Valley, and Lisby couldn't pick out Parker.
Well, it looks when this man's on the ball here, Fraser, very calm and composed. Him and Tedic, you think it's going to be the key link-up for Charlton this evening.
He's nicknamed the Scottish Pirlo, apparently, after a free kick goal against Shrewsbury last season. I won't ask you what your nicknames were.
It was nothing like Pirlo. He does look smooth, though, I will say. And I think this kind of game needs that little bit of calm, doesn't it? It can be very frantic, very manic. Somebody just to put the foot on the ball, steady it down and get Charlton playing.
He did point out plenty of experience out there despite making wholesale changes to the side, and haven't lacked cohesion despite all those alterations. They're on the move again here as well. Half a challenge really by Ibrahim to try and get it away. Kirk. Collected by Eden. Not quite on the right lines with the pass. Haven't been out of their own half for a while, Cray Valley Paper Mills, and still haven't been.
Well, they've got to get hold of the ball in those moments. That's got to find the centre forward, that pass. Give Parker a chance to hold it up and get Cray Valley up the pitch a little bit.
Well, Matt was saying that they've been full of goals this season. They've been full of games as well. Look at that run. Eight matches in order to make it through to the first round of the FA Cup. And one of the sides they overcame was his former team, Carl Shulton, after a replay.
I mean, I saw their fixtures. I think they've only played five league games, haven't they? I'm not surprised with that amount of cup fixtures to fit in.
Well, their success in the cup competitions means that By my reckoning, they've got 15 games scheduled between now and New Year's Day.
I mean, that's three a week probably. It's a Monday night, a Wednesday night and a Saturday.
Imagine the Premier League managers. Yeah.
There'd be a few complaints, wouldn't there?
Here's Lisby, and there's a free kick for the Millers, which the away fans feel is somewhat overdue from Benjamin Speedy. Lee clips it to no one in particular, but that's come out for Vigor. Anderson with a bit of showboating there that doesn't come off, trying to nibble back in with the challenge, and it came off of Banqua last. Seydou's throw back here for Arthur Lee, who scored a vital goal in that run to the first round this season against his former club Carshalton. Got a couple of players with him from his ex-club, Steve McKim, and the club captain amongst the handful that have joined him, as out comes Walker to smash that clear.
A little bit uncertain there between the goalkeeper and Thomas, left side centre back. I think they've just got to hope to put pressure on those situations as well, Cray Valley, try and maybe force an error at the back or some kind of slip up.
It is the goalkeeper's first appearance for the club since he joined on a short-term deal last month as cover for the injured Harry Eisted. And might be a little bit rusty. That's a useful pass. But across to deal with it is Lucas Ness. Good anticipation by Ibrahim. Here's Williams. Ademolui. Needs some support, although he's still got the ball. Back for Williams. Vigor, handy ball! Well, Lisby was the man going for it, unfortunately. There was also a flying challenge in the way from James Abankwa.
Well, that's a great challenge from Abankwa. I think that's a cross from Williams, but it ends up being a great pass and really good position from Lisby. He's in a great angle here to hit this first time with his right foot. And look at that tackle, right on cue.
Corner, though, not fully dealt with. Ademolui urged to shoot, goes for the pass. Here's Barney Williams. That's a handy ball and perhaps deserve better.
That's more like it. From Cray Valley, I've been impressed with Black's start to the game. I think he's done well in the centre of midfield. His anticipation, winning balls back, has been really good. But that's a far better delivery into the box. It really does ask a question. Just can't get over the top of it.
Sonny Black in the middle of the park for Cray Valley Paper Mills, who was the player of the year voted for by the manager last season. Sonny Black, released by Palace back in 2015.
I can see that just from the start of this game. He's looked good in the heart of midfield.
Abankwa, Anderson. Anderson will get to that again. Campbell. Kirk's in plenty of space on this near side if they can switch it. And eventually it comes his way. Thomas finding Ness. Here's Abankwa. Completely different side that Michael Appleton has named is with the league campaign firmly in mind. They've got a big match against the current leaders, Portsmouth, on the horizon, and are sniffing around the playoff places at the moment in what is a very competitive League One.
I suppose the build-up to these games is very different for both teams as well. Tuesday night, wasn't it, Charlton? I think Cray Valley haven't played since last Saturday, so sometimes that lag into the game maybe isn't a good thing over a week of waiting, especially for the players in preparation for this match. I'm sure they've done a lot of work on the training field in that time.
And Charlton have generally managed to avoid being on the end of upsets in games against non-league teams in the FA Cup. Just one of their 20 ties against non-league opposition has gone against them. 1-0 away at Northwich Victoria in the first round back in 2009. On course to avoid an upset today. In fact, Michael Appleton said that in these kind of situations, he warns his players to aim to be just a paragraph in the papers rather than amongst the headlines. Just a footnote saying that they've got the job done.
And it's interesting possession statistics, as you'd expect, really. Charlton are always going to dominate the ball.
Ness. Campbell was looking for Kuroi Anderson. It looked like Lee had a handful of shirt there. Referee didn't buy it though. Adamalui. Risky. And Ibrahim gets the free kick he was hoping he was going to get.
I think Tedic is going to know he's been in a game at the end of this. Judging from the start of how Lee wants to play and defend, wants to get tight, wants to be aggressive with his position.
They're not moving at full speed there, Boban Tedic. On loan from Manchester City, Tedic. He apparently cost City just over £2 million back in September of 2019. Tidied up here by Eden, and then off Barney Williams for a Charlton Athletic throw.
I mean, it really was a lovely little piece of quality from Tedic for the goal. I know he didn't touch the ball, but just to have the awareness of leaving his legs open, letting the ball roll through, knowing exactly what's behind him, it was a clever play from him. And that is the difference, isn't it? That is what we're talking about. That separates this game.
Fraser, a man whose goal is the difference at the moment, and has lost out. Ibrahim's ball in, not the most convincing defending.
I thought Walker was going to come for that one, but decided to stay on his line, and the ball just went harmlessly in the end across that 6-yard box line, but it was certainly a dangerous area for nobody to deal with it.
Well, he is very experienced, over 350 career appearances, 200 or so of them for Colchester, but as mentioned, it's his first game for Charlton since he joined last month. Eden back to Sam Walker. Parker putting the pressure on. Campbell with the control. Lovely stuff. Brilliant stuff there from Chem Campbell.
Yeah, brings the ball down really nicely. It was really round his throat, wasn't it? Just took the pace right out of it. Lovely touch.
Has played in the Premier League for Wolves. 6 appearances, though all of them from the bench. Was actually in the same Birmingham City youth team as Jude Bellingham. He made his Wolves debut when he was only 16 years of age. Looking to try and use this as a bit of a springboard to get back at the top table. McRandles, Campbell, that's clever. McRandles onto it, 3 in the area, and he can't find any of them. That is a bit of a waste.
I thought he might have just gone for goal there. maybe a tight angle, but there's enough there for a shot. Nobody come out to press him.
Thomas. Now Ness. Banqua. McCrandles. Campbell on the turn. Chem Campbell. Ooh, that's risky. Anderson's in. Bit messy in there from the Millers. And then Williams thundering in. Tumkaya. Met by Thomas.
Not a bad ball from Tumkaya there. Just trying to hit Parker, get it into him.
Step up in quality, of course, but they have been a real goal threat in the competition this season. 24 goals in their 8 matches to get here. The most of any side that has got through to the first round. Nair. Have been flashes, but nothing more than that from the Millers so far. Oof, that's really loose. Here's Black. Parker sends it back nicely. It's Sonny Black. Just took too long to get the shot away, and by the time that he did, there were a number of red shirts between him and Walker's goal.
And Thomas did well there just to come out and just close that angle and get that block in.
There might be a bit light at the back here. Kirk is going to have a pop and may wish that he hadn't have bothered.
We were talking about what the best chance is for Cray Valley. Are they going to create something, or is there going to be a small mistake at the back? And there it is right there, the pass from Ness. Gets that one wrong. They just don't quite make enough of it. They can't get players forward quick enough and into the right spaces. And Charlton get out and just about deal with it.
McCrandles. Thomas. Enjoying himself so far. Abankwa's collected it and has gone for it. Corner.
Well, obviously fancied the volley, didn't he? Just teed himself up. Campbell again, causing havoc on that right-hand side. And there's the strike. Would have been some goal if that goes in the top corner.
He's got experience in the Italian top flight, the 19-year-old. Played against Bologna and Juventus for Udinese last season, who he is on loan from. Fraser over the corner, down in front of the Cray Valley Paper Mills fans. Campbell. Anderson. Firm but fair. Now. What have the Millers got on the counter here? Vigor wanted it. It's gone the other way. Lisby. Not going to get anything for that.
That's great recovery from Abankwa. Really good pace to get back at Lisby there. Thought the break was on, didn't you?
Yeah.
Here's Kirk. Eden. McCrandles. Abankwa. Caroy Anderson. McCrandles. Now Abankwa. Seydou across to try and hold him up. McCrandles feeding Campbell. Vigor. Oof, given away badly. Tedic, good save.
Good save from Freeman. Surprised his punch in the air. Doesn't hesitate here. Tedic gets the ball. He's got one thing in mind. It's not a bad effort. He goes for the near post with a little bit of height. It's a good clean strike. I think it nearly did do the goalkeeper there. He caught the side of his hand. He didn't really get a clean touch. And here's the break. A moment ago, good challenge there. Really fair tackle. Referee in good position, but they just don't make the most of it. A little bit hesitant with the pass, but really good pace from the Charlton right back to get back in.
A couple of players have gone down from that corner. Campbell. Caroy Anderson stabbed it forwards, but Scott Fraser wasn't anticipating it. For not getting the free kick for the challenge on Parker. Caroy Anderson almost dispossessed by Sonny Black. Abankwa. Campbell has been dispossessed. Oh, it looked a bit harsh.
Looked a little bit harsh. Again, the referee, very clear view of it. He's been impressive. Campbell, first touch is good, but then he kind of half loses the ball. He stumbles a little bit, but I don't think that's intended. I think that's just a coming together.
That battle on the far side is Clem against Chem. At the moment, you'd say Campbell coming out on top against Seydou. Crunching challenge from Eden. And he's done some damage to Michael Adam-Louis.
He just leaves his leg in there, Adam Louis. I mean, he's such an honest attempt to win the ball back, but look at the position of his ankle in that block tackle. His right ankle just takes the full brunt of that kick through.
Well, to round up all of this weekend's FA Cup action, we've got a highlights programme on BBC 3 tonight from 8 o'clock. There's a repeat at 11:30 on BBC 2. And you can always find every single FA Cup goal from now until May on the BBC Sport website and app. And there are two games in the Premier League tonight on Match of the Day 2. That is at 10:30 on BBC One. I think that Steve McKim would probably take 1-0 at half time because they're still in it.
Absolutely. I mean, it's not been a bad game, actually. I know the possession will always be Charlton's, the majority, but they've had a couple of little breakaways. When they get the ball in the box, they look a little bit of a threat, and there's some players that haven't played a lot of football for Charlton, and as the game goes on, they haven't had the match minutes, the tiredness might set in, it affects your decision making as well. It's nicely poised.
On by McCrandles. Backwork, good stuff. And across the deal with him is Arthur Lee, and it's at the expense of a corner.
Well, I think Lee was too sure whether or not he could step in and make that tackle there. Good work coming from this right-hand Charlton side again. As he has that touch there, look at Lee. He wants to come in and tackle, but he probably does the right thing in just standing up tall. Not allowing the ball to come through.
And Anderson went for the short one. It goes to Fraser short instead. Now it is Anderson. Nice idea, but it was also anticipated by Vigor. And Fraser will happily accept another corner. That's a better delivery, and that should have been 2-0. Chem Campbell arriving. Plenty of power, but no placement.
Well, from our position, we've got a great view of this. We're right along the line of this header. I mean, he cleanly wins it. He has to hit the target there. If he hits the target with that kind of power, it's in the back of the net, and it should be.
He'd have stuck that away all day long.
All day long. That's one thing I could do okay.
Steve Kim's a black cab driver and turns up to most of his matches in his Hackney carriage. He told me he used to cover the Clapham area, which is my neck of the woods. I had a horrible moment wondering if he might have picked me up in the early hours after a late night on the high street.
Outside a kebab shop.
I didn't ask him, too fearful. Lisby after that, but not getting any change out of a Banqua. Sonny Black. Now Lee. Charlton have the advantage, but you wouldn't say it's obvious that there's five leagues and 117 places between the clubs.
No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't, but you're looking at a very different Charlton team, which probably makes it a little bit more of a leveller. I mean, you're still talking about players that have good experience and are playing in the Football League and what have you, but it's quite a nice kind of level playing field here at the moment. I think you can see the quality from Charlton for sure, but Cray Valley, they're applying a little bit of pressure. They're competing really well, I have to say that. Physically, they look pretty good at the moment.
Chemtum Kaya. Here's Lee. Oh, that's nowhere near Lisby.
I mean, they're the problems that Cray Valley have. Just that quality into the front needs to be better.
Michael Appleton said anyone that knows him knows that he takes every single cup competition seriously, but it is also an opportunity to use your squad as best as you possibly can. It keeps the players fit, and that's why he made such a big thing about trying to stay in the EFL trophy for as long as they possibly can as well. So it's not rotation to necessarily protect his frontline players, but also to ensure that the rest of the squad are match sharp.
He's certainly using the squad to the full degree in this game, isn't he? I mean, 11 changes is huge, but it's working out okay so far.
I'd say that there's a pretty decent amount of cohesion given that it's a completely different 11.
Yeah, you have to say it's credit to him as a manager. He's only been in charge 10 games, but I think he's got very clear identity about how he plays, and everyone will be learning that and trying to understand that. It's another reason why to play players, so they can implement what they're learning on the training pitch and what they're watching maybe when they're on the bench if they're not playing regularly. That's important that everyone's on the same page.
Oh, I get it. Page, Paper Mills. Yeah.
That was completely unintended.
Here's Fraser. That's a very handy ball. Charlie Kirk will get to it. Not the greatest first touch. That's a better ball, though. And I think the pressure from Arthur Lee did just about enough to prevent a clean strike on goal.
Yeah, it's good defending from the centre-back. Nice ball wide, right into the path. And a little shimmy here. The ball comes in off his left foot. And look at Lee's position. Just the right side with his body in contact with Tedic. Doesn't allow him a free strike on goal. Good defending.
Oh,
was an interesting challenge. Referee didn't see anything wrong with it and has given the free kick there.
Watching a bit of judo at the moment. It's a little kind of throw over the shoulder here from Lee. Certainly is a physical battle between these two, both enjoying it. Maybe Lee enjoying it a little bit more than Tedic.
That felt like a proper FA Cup first round challenge, didn't it? Well, plenty of huff and puff from the Millers. Just lacking that finesse in the final third, but they have made a good fist of it and they're set to go in at the break, still very much in the equation. They've battled back from some tough positions in the earlier rounds of this competition as well, going to replays when they've almost been out of the competition.
I mean, they've responded well since going behind as well, I have to say. Didn't let their heads go down.
Freeman's clearance. Thomas. Nicely sprayed for Eden to chase and get to and come inside, and then he's dispossessed. Although that's coughed up in a bad area. Anderson, Abakwa, Tenich, harmless. From a comfort for the Millers, Charlton have conceded 30 goals in their 18 matches this season. They've been good going forwards, but seemed a bit suspect at the back. They've tightened up since Michael Appleton came in, that's for sure. But even the game against Wigan in the week, when they were 3-0 up and cruising, they allowed the Latics to creep back into it. Anderson and Lee slides in to clear, and that is the last action of the half. So no upset on the cards at the moment. Michael Appleton's much changed team in front at the interval, courtesy of Scott Fraser's cool finish. There's been a lot of effort from the Millers, but they have failed to give their fans much to stand up and shout about. But Matt Upson, I think overall they'll be relatively pleased with their performance.
Yeah, I agree. It's been a close battle, an interesting game to watch, really only separated by a real nice piece of quality and awareness from Tedic and a nice through ball. So very, very close. He'll go in at half-time, speak to his team, and I think they'll come back out in the second half and have a real go.
As for Charlton, much change, but again, Michael Appleton won't be disappointed.
No, when you make that many changes, it's not going to be as cohesive and as solid as what you'd expect. There's some young players on the pitch as well, so he'll be relatively pleased and happy with his team's performance as well.
So still up for grabs then at half-time at the Valley. Charlton Athletic 1, Cray Valley Paper Mills 0.
Mark and Matty, thank you both very much indeed. Well, looking at the stats, 69% possession for Charlton Athletic, 12 shots, as opposed to 31% of the ball for Cray Valley. But the fact is, Joby, that they're still in this.
Very much so. And I think particularly after conceding so early on, you want to come here and try and keep it as tight as you can. And I just don't think they quite got to grips with the game that first 20 minutes or so. I think the occasion and the atmosphere maybe just overawed them a little bit, gave the ball away too cheaply. But actually, after that sort of 20 minutes, they grew into the game and have had some decent opportunities themselves.
Paul, early couple of minute nerves, do you think?
Yeah, like Joby said, they didn't believe they should be here. It took them 20 minutes to get into the game and obviously a goal behind, but once they settled in, they made a few passes and they believed they should be on the pitch against Charlton Athletic today.
Let's take a look at the goal, Joby, because quite frankly, Charlton Athletic found too much space, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. And again, it's good play initially, but you'll see the left back just gets picked out and then Fraser makes a really good run, but too big a gap between the right back and his centre-half pairing in the end, a relatively simple finish. You can see here on this angle, Asaidu goes in there, trying to press, doesn't get tight enough. And then again, it's just the timing of the run.
Yeah, it's a great run, isn't it?
Really, really good. And again, the release of the pass was absolutely perfect and really composed to just take it around the keeper and slot it in.
Yeah, far too much space, isn't it, Paul?
Yeah, there is, and like you say, the two centre-halves need to close that gap, but Sonny Black, he ends up at left-back, where him and the left-back could maybe swap over where maybe that goal don't happen.
Lovely little over from Tedic in the build-up as well there, just awareness, knowing that runner's just being made behind him, and then, as I say, once he gets in there, really, really smart finish.
Yeah, cool finish. I think Mark in commentary, and we were saying watching the game as well, that Cray Valley need to get hold of the ball, get up the pitch, and just have a go.
Yeah, and listen, again, it was that first 20 minutes or so. There were times you're working so hard off the ball, of course. We know that Charlton are going to dominate it. But that first pass, when you do win it back, that regain, just to give yourself a chance to get up the pitch with a bit of control and a bit of quality, they just lacked at times.
Yeah, a couple of half chances. Bit of joy down the right-hand side, Paul.
Yeah, they've done really well. You know, Adam Louis, he's causing havoc out on the left-hand side. He's quick and he's pacey. And here you see Lisby has a great chance and a great defending as well to block the shot.
I think it's one occasion where they're just having a bit of composure, working the ball into these areas. This was a real good delivery.
Ball in as well.
Fantastic, just to that back post area, just a little bit too high. But this is what they need to do more, put that Charlton back line, which is much changed, under pressure. And when they did that, they looked like they could carry a bit of a threat.
Yeah, fitness may play a big part in today's tie.
Yeah, I think so. I think the longer the game goes on, the more running they have to do to try and get on the ball, their legs might start cramping up, and that's time for when the manager has to make changes. And hopefully they might nick one chance if they get one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, you can see them, as I say, these little opportunities here, just growing in confidence as the half went on. It's just that little bit of quality when they do get into that final third. No, we know they have got goals in there, so it's just trying to find that moment.
The one thing you need to do, though, no doubt, if you are going to cause an upset, is make sure when you got the ball, you look after it as well, Joby.
100%, and I think that's been the big difference, again, just in terms of enabling Cray Valley to get up the pitch in good areas. I mean, this one here, you just go to your other centre-half there and just keep possession.
For it's me, so it's cheap,
just,
isn't it,
Joby? It's just force, you know, yeah. And when you are up against it and chasing, again, Ibrahim here on a couple of occasions, again, just play your right winger. He's standing in front of you, maybe doesn't help him by running away, but then gets himself in the mix, and then all of a sudden you're having to defend a situation again.
Yeah, I think as well, Joby, you'd say as well, like, you can, when you've got the football, that's when you're time to relax and take your time, and you have more control with when you've got it, rather than without it.
It's just knowing where that first pass is going to go. Again, here, you know, simple position, just a sloppy pass and it leads to a shot, and that's what certainly you don't want Tedic there getting a shot off. But again, I think for them it's a real, they're in now, it's only 1-0, can we just tighten up a little bit, but particularly when we're in possession of the ball, just to give ourselves a chance. And again, at the moment, I think the manager will be happy.
Yeah, a couple of times you've said as we're watching the game, relax when you're in possession of the ball, but that's easier said than done, isn't it, given the fact that there's such a gulf in class here.
It is, and it does become more difficult when you haven't got the ball, but I think the times they have gotten given the ball away, they haven't been under massive pressure, and I think the manager would expect them to deal with those situations a little bit better than they have done in that first half.
Paul, pleased with Charlton so far?
Yeah, I think they look dangerous, expected, especially Anderson and Campbell on the wing. I think they look really, really lively. Fraser's getting forward well, and I expect him to get a goal in this half if it keeps going the way it is.
OK, boys, for the moment, thank you very much indeed. Four other ties played today. Let's show you the best of the action from some of them.
Mandeville and near the ball, Darren Aldacre as well. Whipped into the box and Norris has been beaten to it. Headed home by Tom Naylor.
It's a magnificent delivery, it really is, from Mandeville. And there is Tom Naylor to get the all-important touch and put the National League leaders in front.
game's starting to open up now as Grimsby Town chase the equaliser. Efete over on the far side, and that's the equaliser! And it had to be him, Danny Rose. Look at this from Efete here. Really good pace to that delivery. And Danny Rose timed that run perfectly. Lutheran with absolutely no chance.
It's been a fantastic weekend of FA Cup action right across the BBC. Two other results this afternoon. Fleetwood Town had to come from behind to see off non-league Kidderminster Harriers. Sean Rooney scored the winner for the League One side. Derby County got two late goals to earn a replay against Crewe Alexandra. Don't forget, you can see highlights of all the games from the FA Cup first round tonight, 8 o'clock on BBC 3 or later on BBC 2. And Chappers will have the best of the Premier League Match of the Day 2 featuring Forest against Villa and Luton Town against Liverpool. BBC 1 tonight at 10:30. Well, also, the second round draw took place earlier today. Non-league Chesterfield, who knocked out League One leaders Portsmouth today. They're at home to Leighton Orient. Aldershot, who scored 7 at Swindon yesterday. Sorry, Swindon fans. That's the second time we've mentioned that tonight. They'd be drawn against Stockport County. Alfreton of the National League North host Walsall. Blackpool, who beat Bromley in our live game last night, will play Scarborough or Forest Green. But a bit of an attractive tie for National League side Eastleigh. They're at home to League One Reading. The winners of this tie tonight will travel to Gillingham for another local derby. And Ramsgate, 8th tier, last out of the hat. Their reward for beating Woking is a trip to AFC Wimbledon. Joby, any of those take your fancy?
You mentioned it there, but certainly the Reading won, a real big morale boosting victory for them to get to the next round. But going to Eastleigh will be, again, a real tricky one. You know, they had a great result yesterday, so that's definitely one that I'm looking out for.
Yeah, Paul, what about you?
I think the winners from tonight's game going down to Gillingham down the road, it's another derby.
He's so Charlton Athletic, isn't he?
It's another nice derby to go down to.
Fantastic. So delighted to say that Kevin Lisby joins us. Kev, hello, good evening to you. Welcome. Lovely to see you. We've got a bit of a treat for you as well, okay? Yeah. So have a look at this screen here. Talk us through this. Before we start talking about your boy, do you remember this? 2003 hat-trick against Liverpool?
Yeah, I'm not allowed to talk about this no more, but yeah. I mean, that's the first one, and the second one's just reactive and just in the box waiting for that chance and a little tapping. The third one, getting assist from Dino here, driving, I think, is this 35 yards or 45 yards?
I need to ask you about the dance after as well.
Yeah, it's a West Indian dance.
I don't know whether it was 35 or 45 yards, but we had to dust off the 12. Tapes, that's for sure. And what have you made of the boys so far tonight then?
Yeah, I think they've stuck in there, which is what they had to do. I think it's been difficult at times because you can see Charlton have obviously a full-time club and the boys are moving a little bit differently than the Cray Valley boys, but they're stuck in there and now they've got the second half and they're attacking the home fans.
What a proud day for you though, Kyrell as well. I mean, it must be wonderful in the Lisby household at the moment.
Yeah, I think, anyone that knows me knows that he's worked really hard to get to this point and to be filming here at the Valley on live TV at Charlton, against Charlton, is a massive day for me and all the family.
Kev, surely you got onto Steve McQueen and asked if maybe you get yourself on the bench tonight, yeah. Old Cray Valley player.
There was a conversation, though.
Hey, breaking news.
It ended really quickly, though.
What's it like, though? What sort of dad are you, though? Are you a shouty dad? Are you a, come on, son, you can do this type of dad?
I'd like to think I'm a reflective dad. Like, <it's> like, he probably would disagree with that. But, yeah, I want my kids to be happy and get the best out of them, and he's worked really hard to get to this point, and I'm proud of him and all my kids.
Bless you, man.
Yeah. Kev, just what's it been like in the build-up? Because players that play at a higher level will expect, and understand there's going to be a lot of exposure that comes with it. But obviously for Kyrell, there's been interviews, there's been media interest. How's he dealt with that in the lead-up to this game?
Yeah, he's a very calm character. Sometimes I'm wondering if he's taking all this in and what's happening, but I think he's enjoying the moment. I think, more importantly, he's doing well in the league as well. He's scoring goals. So I think that's really important that he keeps up that good run of scoring goals and performing. But I think he's taking this game as a game. It's an opportunity for him to go out there and showcase his talent before he goes back onto league games.
What about Kai Reese? Is he feeling left out tonight or is he here?
Yeah, I walked past him just a minute ago. He said, Dad, I feel like it's me playing. I said, son, it's not. Yeah, it's not. It's your brother.
But it must be so different when you consider the gap and the gulf in class between them, with the greatest respect.
Oh, yeah, listen, they're full-time players. They're surrounded by full-time coaches. and their mentality is going to be good as well. So, yeah, listen, for the boys to still be in this 1-0 is a great chance for them. I think if they get an opportunity, if they take it, then it's everything to play for.
Yeah, thoughts on the second half?
I just feel like we need to keep in our shape a little bit more. At times, we look a little bit ragged. If we keep in our shape and then we catch him on the counter, who knows? Every chance.
When you say we, I'm a bit confused. What's happening here?
I said that a few times before, didn't I? Yeah. I do apologise. Kyrell, should I say.
Paul, what was it like to play alongside Kev?
Yeah, it was good. He was an outlet. He was quick and, like we've seen there, he knew where the goal was. And good in the air. You can see Kyrell has got a little bit of him, Kevin in him.
Yeah. Fantastic. And what about your involvement at the moment with the club?
With Cray?
Yeah.
I'm a sit down and watch that at the moment. Yeah. Listen, I was at Cray Valley for 4 years. We went to Wembley in the Cup. So it's a real affiliation with me and obviously Charlton as well. So it's good just to be in the middle of this and watch this game and take it all in.
Such a wonderful story, isn't it, Joby?
It is, although it makes me feel a little bit old. I said I played with Kev and now Kyrell's playing.
I know.
Cole Lieburn I played with and his son's on the bench tonight.
You're getting old, pal.
I'm getting tired.
You've got to accept it, innit?
Kev, let me just ask you about Charlton Athletic because, of course, Michael Appleton's made a number of changes today as well. Yeah. Big game against Pompey on Saturday in the league.
Yeah, I mean, I was here, I'd done the Bolton game as well. That was a massive game. Bolton 1-2-0, so I think they would want to bounce back another home performance. The games I've commentated in here, they've done really well. So I'm hoping that they get a good result against Portsmouth.
Yeah, Paul, hopeful this season?
Yeah, I am hopeful. You can see Charlton have changed, they have changed managers. They're playing more on the front foot, and hopefully if he can still implement what he wants to do with the team, then hopefully they can climb the league.
Yeah, and they've got a good goal scorer in Alfie May, Joe.
Yeah, absolutely. Top draw. I saw a lot of him, certainly at Charlton. 20 goals in his last couple of years there. He's really been absolutely brilliant so far this season as well. So certainly you need that goal scoring instinct, and certainly has got that.
Kev, really good to see you. Best wishes to you and your family. You must be a very proud man this evening. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on the BBC. Thank you very much. So can Cray Valley get back into it tonight?
What a chance, and surely 1-0 Charlton. Good save. So no upset on the cards at the moment.
So here we go. Second half about to get underway. Let's hand you back to Matthew Upson and Mark Scott.
Thank you very much indeed, Jason, and no changes from either manager at the interval either. Matt Upson, a real surprise, I guess. They both have been fairly satisfied with that first 45.
Yeah, absolutely no surprise that they're both happy. Send out the same starting 11 and seeing if the game can really bring anything more to us. It's been a really interesting contest so far. Let's hope it continues.
So it will be Cray Valley Paper Mills to kick off this second half. By the way, the draw for the second round has been made, and whoever is victorious between these two won't have very far to travel in the next round. Gillingham away is the prize on offer for either Cray Valley Paper Mills or Charlton Athletic. Freddie Parker got a little nick on that. It's come the way of Lisby. Lisby wasn't what he intended, but still got it into the area. Carol Lisby, we saw his father Kevin at half time. Kevin actually runs, or has run, a coaching school for forward players, and Carroll's been along to it, and so has Miles Lieburn as well. And Carl is in attendance somewhere here tonight too. Asedu, this is a pretty bright start to the second half from the Millers. Asedu's ball in, and stretching, Walker just about deals with it.
Yeah, gets a hand on it there, Walker. Look very casual in that, really confident and calm that he was going to get hold of the ball. bright start to the second half. Just adjusts his position there with his left hand, just taps it, manages to take the pace off it and gather it up.
Thomas to Eden. Early spray forward, looked offside to me there, Tedic. Play goes on. McRandles. Vigo has lost it. Fraser is onto it. Campbell, who was probably the standout performer in the first half, has got that in handily. Abankwa, useful! Gathered safely by Sam Freeman.
Good position from Williams, the right back. Came inside the pitch and defensively really did his job there at the back post.
They've equaled their best ever FA Cup run by getting to the first round proper, the Millers. Did it in 2020, lost by a goal to nil in that tie to Havant. Waterlooville, here's Lisby. That's a good ball, it's in! Kyrell Lisby with a big hand in a leveller for the Millers at the Valley. Look at the scenes in the away end. 2,000 or so Cray Valley paper mill supporters go absolutely nuts. And while it wasn't his goal, wouldn't you just know that Kyrell Lisby has come to the party at Charlton Athletic. It's 1-1.
Well, it certainly felt like a really good start to this second half. It's all about Sonny Black for me. Brilliant play from him in midfield. The way he wins that ball, look at that pass outside the right boot. Lovely ball in from Lisby. Right in that channel. And from a centre-back's perspective here, it's near on impossible to defend a good quality ball in that area. He doesn't get there, Ness. And all he can do is just turn it into his own net. But brilliant play from Sonny Black in midfield to win the ball and then thread that little pass through was top class.
Cray Valley Paper Mills changing the script somewhat. Abankwa. Here goes Campbell. Can Campbell, dangerous! And Charlie Kirk passes up a massive chance to re-establish the lead.
Great opportunity for Kirk. Lovely play from Campbell. Standout performance for Charlton. Lovely ball. His body shape here, for me, he's always leaning back from Kirk. He never really gets his upper body over the top of the ball. He's just got to keep this low. And just stabs at it really with his left foot.
Lisby. Fraser, just overlooking it, and not sure if you enjoyed that or you were wincing about Barney Williams' challenge there.
Well, a little bit of both, I think. I don't see too many of them tackles. That is a FA Cup tackle, isn't it? On a cold evening.
They will have enjoyed that just as much as they enjoyed that own goal from Ness that has levelled things up. Williams has missed that one, though. And is fortunate it's come the way of Arthur Lee. Just get the feeling there might have been a rocket at half-time.
Yeah, it certainly started like that in this second half.
Adem Alui, free kick. And all of a sudden, for the first time in the game, it feels as though the non-league side are the ones on top.
I mean, look at his face, Adem Alui. I think he might be enjoying himself at the moment in front of the away fans that are way more than what they're used to playing in front of at home, really enjoying lifting the support behind that goal.
Around about 2,000 in that away end tonight. Their average gate is only 150.
A And Williams has put his tackling boots on as well, hasn't he? Yeah. A couple of challenges in this second half.
Barney Williams will take the free kick for Valley. Lee is a big danger in there. Williams ball in. Lee didn't get there. Lisby. Oof, nearly sold that short. Out comes Walker. Oh, and that's not convincing either. Fraser. Lovely pass. It's Kirk. It's a big save. Fraser. Kirk again. Proper cup tie this now. Fraser's ball in.
A lovely pass from Fraser again with a cool head.
McCrandles. Anderson. Now a back one. Teasing ball, that should be the keeper's. It's off the bar, in fact. And more action in the first 7 minutes of the second half than we saw in the entirety of the first.
That's been a brilliant start to this half. Right in the balance at the moment, this game. Off the top of the crossbar, I mean, Freeman backpedalling. You'd like to think he would have dealt with it. But here's that moment from Fraser. Gets his head up, threads that ball through. I love how Freeman just stays big for so long. He doesn't overcommit. He says to Kirk, you're going to have to pick your spot here. Brilliant save from the keeper.
He was one of Steve McKim's first signings this summer, joining from Whitehawk. Lisby was in space, but Ibrahim couldn't find him and then committed the foul. And it's going to be brought back.
Well, this is where it becomes a big test for a team that doesn't play together week in, week out. A lot of changes down there for Charlton. This is going to be a big test for their character.
Well, they have got some big hitters on the bench, Charlton. Blackett Taylor, Leeburn, and of course Alfie May.
And don't be surprised if you start to see a couple of them soon.
Anderson sends it off. Campbell. Banqua, Chem Campbell, lifted in nicely, Williams underneath it, Anderson, Kirk. It's just three clean sheets in 19 games in all competitions for Charlton this season. Here's Campbell meanwhile though. Good run, lovely dribble, and wants a penalty. Benjamin Speedy not minded to give it.
Oh, tight, wasn't it? From where I'm standing, that looked just about the right decision. Be good to see it closer up, but lovely run again from Campbell. You feel that he's the key, isn't he? He's going to unlock it on this right-hand side. His movement, little give and goes. He wants to run in behind.
Campbell. Nice dummy by Fraser. Teddick sent it on. This is Kirk. And this is better from Charlton. Eden deflected. Goal kick.
I thought the cutback was on then. I think it was Kirk just ran into that position, wanted a pass. Cut back from the goal line. But they must still be complaining about that penalty decision from the referee. Here it is. I'm not sure how much contact is made from Williams. He tries to cut on the inside of him, and I just don't think the referee's sure there's enough contact there.
Now, as you say, looks like being the key for Charlton, having struggled to make a bit of an impact so far this season. He'd only started three games before this evening. Tevic. Campbell. There's room for Kirk on the far side. And here he is now. Fraser. And it was a pitching wedge when it needed to be a driver.
Well, I think he's too happy with the setback pass that he got. He wanted to hit this first time, or maybe from a different angle. Campbell again driving into the heart of the pitch. Good timing release of the pass, and Cray Valley really scrapping hard to get back in and get bodies around that, put enough pressure on the pass, but Fraser knows he's got better quality than that.
Another great first quarter of an hour or so for Michael Appleton's men. Hesitation here, and hooked away by Thomas. Kirk. Campbell. McCrandles. A back run. Campbell. Now Caroy Anderson. Tandle has seen the decision go Charlton's way.
Well, Black really applying pressure there. Looked a little bit soft that for me. He's had a good game so far for his team.
Action on the Charlton bench. Michael Appleton might be shuffling his pack soon, which isn't a massive surprise given the way that the start of the second half has panned out. And this doesn't look good.
No.
Well, there didn't seem to be any major coming together, but you can see the distress on his face there. He must feel that his race is run for the day.
I mean, hopefully he's just disappointed that he may have to come off. It's a big night for the Cray Valley players. They've given a great account of themselves. May just be a bit of cramp. Here's the goal that's well worth looking at again for me. Brilliant play, Ibrahim, outside the right boot. Feeds it into a great area. And the cross from Lisby is right in that channel. Ness outstretched, can't get anything on it. Look at those fans.
Well, he might be heading off. Charlton definitely are making some changes. Nathan Asimwe is one of those coming on. We're going to see Tenai Watson as well. And also Alfie May is going to be drafted in as well. He has been scoring goals for fun this season, Alfie May. League One's joint top scorer, level with Barnsley's Devante Cole on 11. 7 goals in his last 6 starts, and now he'll get half an hour at least tonight. Kevin Lisby is off for the final half an hour of this game. On in his place is Denzel Gale, who is the longest serving player at Cray Valley Paper Mills. This is his 258th appearance for the club.
He has a bit of pace, Gale, as well. I think just some fresh legs to try and liven things up. But Michael Appleton bringing on May. It's the kind of ace up his sleeve, isn't it, to try and put this game to bed.
May immediately into the thick of it and has put in a handy ball, which comes to nothing in the end.
There's a bit of a bang to the hip in this move here. Work it out to May, just drags that cross through the legs. A lot of bodies in there. They really have fought hard in this game, defended well actually, Cray Valley. Have to give them a lot of credit for how they've set up.
And there's confirmation of that change with Karel Lisby having created the chance that led to the leveller, but forced off and devastated that his evening's come to a premature end. As I say, Denzel Gale is the longest serving player currently on the books at Cray Valley Paper Mills, and along with Jem Tumkaya, is one of the two surviving members of their FA Vars final side at Wembley in 2019, when he actually played with Karel Lisby's dad, Kevin. Three changes made, and are they going to need to make another? Chem Campbell will be hoping not, given that he has made the most of a rare start from Michael Appleton tonight.
He looks anxious to keep him on, doesn't he, Michael Appleton? He knows the threat that he's carried in this second half has been big for Charlton. We definitely want to keep him on the pitch, but it's been a real competitive game, hasn't it? I'm not surprised to see a few bodies having taken quite a knock in some real solid tackles.
What has changed in this second half? Because Cray Valley Paper Mills have just had so much more of the game.
Well, I think you have that first half and you're a little bit unsure, you don't quite know what to expect, and I think they've realised in that first half that we can have a go here, we can actually maybe win this game. And in credit to them, they've got the belief, they've got the confidence to come out and think, right, we're going to be more aggressive, we're going to press a little bit higher up the pitch. I mean, physically, they've coped so far, but we're now getting to that just over an hour mark, and this last 25, 20 minutes is going to be interesting to see if the fitness levels just drop off a little bit.
And that was the area that Steve McKim spoke to me about earlier in the week, that the physicality, nutrition, he mentioned as well, could play a part. That's the massive difference between pro players and part-timers. Having chefs making specialised meals compared to just grabbing a sandwich when you're on the road. Now here's Alfie May. Looking out to that left at the moment. Can play across the front line and always to good effect, Alfie May.
There's a little buzz around the stadium when he gets the ball, isn't there?
That's nicely worked. Anderson. Angle's tough, might make it easier with the turn, and then turned into trouble. Campbell seems to have shaken off that knock. Can't shake off a couple of Miller's defenders. Has to offload to Anderson. Asimwe's ball in. May's effort charged out.
Super defending from Williams, it really is. I mean, he had to adjust his position. He anticipated May onto his right foot. Really good position from the right back and a good block.
The changes seem to have just changed the momentum of the game.
Really kept their discipline well, Cray Valley. Even when they're getting bodies back in quite desperate situations, nobody's overcommitting, nobody's diving in, making rash decisions. That they've really been composed when they're defending.
Thomas. May. That's a rare misstep from him. He gave Cheltenham a shock lead against Manchester City live on the BBC in the fourth round a few years ago. And he's in red hot form for Charlton this season. The last chance striker to hit 11 or more league goals by the end of October was Bradley Wright Phillips with 12 over a decade ago. More of the ball, but all square where it matters. Great effort from the Millers to be all level away at a team that are in and around the playoff places in League One. Parker has been feeding off scraps this evening, and maybe a bit of frustration there. In fact, the decision has gone the Millers' way.
Well, territory, isn't it? Where can they have the ball? They don't need much of it. We've seen that, 30% possession, but it's about where you have in possession and what can you do with it. These kind of areas, keep it simple, set the ball, get it in the box. Ask a question of that Charlton back four, see if they can defend.
Arthur Lee, the latest to hit the turf. They're without Oshilaja this evening, who is suspended, picked up four yellow cards. It's a bit harsh given that they played eight games to get here.
Yeah.
Charlton are playing their first in the competition. They're shorn of one of their number because of four bookings across the eight games.
Yeah, I mean, they need to try and keep Lee on the pitch here. I know he hasn't maybe played that many minutes, but the intensity of this game has just been ratcheted up. And like we said earlier, you're going to get to this 70-minute mark and the calves are going to cramp up, the hamstrings are going to feel heavy. But he's been another standout performer for them. He's been brilliant in the centre-back position.
It's going to be interesting if he goes off, because they don't have another recognised centre-half on the bench.
Well, hopefully it's just a bit of cramp and he just needs to ease the calves off. But you know, the next time he has to really exert himself, 100% max effort, that's when you start to feel those problems. But hopefully he can just guide his way through the game with a bit of experience.
A quarter of the cup tie left to play and all square between the eighth tier team and Charlton Athletic of League One. Black. Pass was on there to Seydou. Ibrahim. Black. That's nice. Here's Clem Seydou. Simwe across to deal with him. And Seydou knocks it out. Lee is back on. Not sure how freely he's moving, mind. So Freddie Parker and Matthew Vigor are going to be withdrawn here, and on in their place Adam Coombs and Julian Anau. So that is a central midfielder and a centre forward coming on, so it is like for like.
Yeah, I don't think there'll be any change or shuffling of players around the pitch. Coombs is going to come on for Parker and lead the line. He's worked hard this evening, not had a lot of delivery into him, you wouldn't expect that, but he's done a decent job. And Vigor has got through a lot of work in that midfield area. Not surprised that the changes are now happening.
Well, he's only 19 years of age, so perhaps the physicality of it catching up with him. Adam Coombs amongst those coming on, and he is a very experienced forward. He actually once scored six goals for Welling in a fourth qualifying round tie back in 2016. A Simway's throw for Charlton Athletic into the final 20 minutes. And out. Gale. Handy ball, and that was a chance and Black couldn't take it. Ibrahim. Almost a costly slip. Brilliant footwork though. Black. And out. Here's Gale. Another good spell from the Millers now. It's been a topsy-turvy second half. Here goes Gale. That's a very good-looking ball initially, but then it bent in towards the keeper. Good couple of minutes, though.
Good couple of minutes. Gale just showing his pace there. I think if they just slip that ball down the sides, he's got the legs to get on the end of it. This is a good cross into the box. Really unexpected slip there. And I think that's probably what caught Black out, to be honest. He wasn't expecting to have that kind of effort on goal. If he'd have set himself ready for that, I'm sure he'd have made much better contact with the ball.
Well, he scored twice this season, but one of them came in the FA Cup, and it could have been another, and a big one for him there. Williams will let that go behind.
And I like the look of him and Ibrahim in that midfield area. Black and Ibrahim for Cray Valley. They've had a good night together.
Well, we didn't get to see Lisby and Leeburn on the pitch together, but Miles Leeburn is going to be introduced for the closing stages of this, and it looks as though Chem Campbell's battle to try and stay on the pitch is over. I spoke to Carl Leeburn yesterday. He said that his son is nothing like him in terms of a player. He's a lot better. His words, not mine.
Well, we're going to see, aren't we? Because he wasn't bad himself, Carl. He's a handful. And I think his son is as well, from what I've seen.
He also paid credit to the time he spent at Chelsea. Miles Leeburn said that he's learnt to play every position on the pitch, including in goal, and that means that he's got real versatility and real ability. McGrandles is the other to depart here. Louis Watson stepping in for him. Free kick. 15 minutes to play, and if Cray Valley Paper Mills can snatch a winner, it would be the biggest away victory in the history of the FA Cup in terms of positions between the clubs involved. There you are, 6 goals in 1 tie for Adam Coombs. 1 goal tonight would do for him.
I did look and see that. I think he's got 9 goals this season. I mean, they've got some goals in their attacking lineup, haven't they? I wonder if Michael Appleton's looking at the team selection and just playing that one over. I mean, it's been good to see his squad playing. I'm sure it's been great for him, a new manager in at the club, seeing what all the other players can do. But this is a tricky moment for Charlton. Maybe even a draw is... what a result that is for Cray Valley.
Didn't quite come the way of Fraser because Williams anticipated it.
And the referee just having a word with Alfie May about backing in there.
They might wish that it was a longer journey home tonight so that they could really drink in what they've experienced, but it's only about a 10-minute drive depending on the traffic from here to their home ground. Ademolui loses out. Anderson, Fraser. They'll gladly take a replay, Cray Valley Paper Mills, but they've already got 15 games slated for between now and New Year's Day. Simwe Anderson. Good defensive discipline from the Millers. No obvious pass, and that forces the error.
Well, it's an ambitious cross, isn't it? It's very deep to be able to whip that ball in.
More than 400 games under his belt in management across each of the top four divisions. As I was saying, it's taken a little bit of time for him to win over the fans, but they've been pleased with the type of football they've seen. The big question for Charlton supporters generally is, are they witnessing another full storm perhaps with the new ownership in place at the club? Global Football Partners still in their infancy at the helm. We haven't seen them come on, but Dobson and Blackett Taylor, two very highly thought of players, and their contracts expire at the end of the season. There's real concern that they might be off to pastures new.
And there's another cramp situation happening on the pitch. There's the foul. The referee feels there's enough contact there, an unfair challenge, but the physio could be busy in this final 12 minutes or so. I'm not sure if they've really created enough good opportunities though, Charlton. I think they've had good individual play in wide area. Campbell's been a real threat, but in terms of really getting the ball, passing and moving and just unlocking that defence, there hasn't quite been enough tonight to create as many chances as probably what they'd like.
Well, the trademark since Appleton's come in has been getting the ball forwards quickly and being on the front foot, and hasn't quite been as full tilt as it has been in other games under him.
Well, not in this second half. They haven't had the ball into Tedic anywhere near enough for me.
Big switch by Ibrahim. And tricky one for Barney Williams to deal with. He's come agonisingly close to a dream scenario in the FA Cup before, Steve McKim. Big Chelsea fan. And in the 1999-2000 season, when he was playing for Hayes, they lost 3-2 in extra time in a second round replay at Hull. They then drew Chelsea at home. He'll be desperate that they at least hang on for a replay today. May's not going to get to that. Usain Bolt wouldn't have got to that. Well, they'll be rested for the Portsmouth game, but there'll be questions about the selection. I think you were saying with the other guys earlier that perhaps it's better to front load your team with your big hitters, and then once the game is won, take them off.
Well, that's one way to look at it, isn't it? And I think that those players would relish more. You into that, you've got the warm-up before the game, your mentality is that you're going to start, you play the game, even if you play 45 minutes and you get that lead or you build a gap, that's probably a safer way to go about it.
I think when Louis was chasing that one down, he's still got plenty left in the tank judging by that run. Fraser, F. Williams, picked up by Sonny Black. They've scored some late goals in the FA Cup so far this season, Cray Valley Paper Mills, and Adam Coombs, who's come on, has got three goals at late stages of matches. Simway. Fired goalwards and Williams underneath it. Free kick.
And frustration for Charlton players and fans alike.
More great discipline from Cray Valley. Defensively, they've been superb. I mean, Williams especially in that right back position, always checking his shoulder, checking his position, in the right place at the right time.
To round up all of the weekend's FA Cup action, we've got a highlight show for you on BBC Three tonight. That's from 8 o'clock. There's a repeat on BBC Two at 11:30 as well. And you can get every single FA Cup goal from now through till May on the BBC Sport website and app. And in the Premier League, two games took place today. You can see highlights of both in Match of the Day 2 later, 10:30, BBC One for that. Long by Freeman. Ademilui. He was outnumbered, but still managed to get it back. Arthur Lee. That's comfort Coombs. Laid it off nicely, and Anau couldn't deliver with the finish. Oh, he knows that was a big chance to be a hero.
Oh, it's just one of those where you just have too much time to think about this shot. Doesn't quite get it right, does he? Not enough clean contact on the ball to hit the target. A lot of time to think about it, but you're right. Was a nice opening, wasn't it? Teed up nicely.
Here's Gale. Still going, Denzel Gale. Having to double up on him. And he's managed to push for the throw. Doing their best to try and suck the ball into the net at that end.
They're finishing strongly, aren't they? There's a real feel around this ground in their supporters that they can win this game.
Nice from Barney Williams. What's the ball in like? It's forced a corner, and didn't they like that down at that end? And the players asking for more from the fans. 5 minutes left to play. And a chance of writing their own FA Cup headlines here. Disappointing corner in the end. This side have only lost one of their 19 games in all competitions this season, and that was against Punjab United in the Kent Senior Cup when they fielded a weakened side. Set to emerge unbeaten from the Valley tonight too. Seydou's throw. Wanted handball there. Watson. Anderson. Simway's in space on the near side. Simway fancies a run here. Still Simway. That's not a great clearance. Fraser. Still Fraser! Couldn't reproduce the quality he showed in the first half.
Well, that's credit to Cray Valley, really. Limiting Charlton to efforts outside the box. Not the best clearance there. Very much a tired clearance. But Fraser on his left foot. I mean, he's got to hit some effort to score from there.
Said that his players will want to just be a brief paragraph in the papers and what a headline in these situations. There could still be a big story brewing, although it's Charlton on the attack here. Someway nearly found his way through. May. Williams. Carroy Anderson. Lee Byrne. It's Lee Byrne! Forced the save.
He looks menacing, Lee Byrne, when he's got the ball at his feet. He's got such nice feet for a big fella.
Brentford and Chelsea apparently looking to make a January move for Miles Lee Byrne. Charlton's new owners did say they rejected a £3 million bid from a German club over the summer. Ness. Scott Fraser. Asimwe. Helped away by Anau. Just starting to sit a bit deep now, aren't they?
Yeah, absolutely, but as expected, they're doing it well. You know, they've identified that. They haven't quite got the legs to get out and press and harry the midfield of Charlton, so they've just sat back in, almost in a line of six at the moment. But if that's what they need to do just to see this game through, then so be it.
Williams with the header. Blasted away by Black. Coombs will chase this. Ness. Thomas. Tedic after it. And has got there. Lee Burns in the middle, Alfie May as well. Watson. Nearly. Gale gifted that away.
They've just got to try and get hold of the ball at the moment. Give themselves a breather.
Watson. Fraser. Now then. Ibrahim's held that up well. Charlton have got numbers back though. And out. Ademi Louis. I was looking for the give and go and wanted the free kick, and the referee has given it.
Right under the nose of the referee. Ademi Louis. It's a tricky customer, isn't he? Really kind of gets around the side there, wriggling out of that situation.
Well, he's saying keep your heads, and there's going to be 10 more minutes for all of the Cray Valley Paper Mills players to try and do just that.
I mean, there's been a fair few stoppages, but 10 minutes.
Maybe the ref's just enjoying it like we are.
Maybe.
Now then, Adam Coombs, who has been around the block, very experienced player. Scored some crucial goals in their FA Cup run this season. Is he going to go for goal? It's Adam Coombs. It's on target. And it wasn't a convincing save. He won another free kick, but won't get one this time.
Well, he's lining up. I was actually quite surprised that he had a shot, but he's hit that little dippy shot. Nice technique. He's got that nailed down quite nicely. Made it difficult for the keeper. Had a little bit of movement in it and Walker had to be short.
Played at under 16 and under 17 level for England in the past, Adam Coombs. He's obviously technically gifted. Lee Byrne. Got it back. And then lost it again. Just a question of how courageous Cray Valley Paper Mills want to be in these final few minutes of injury time.
It was great defensive work from Sonny Black in the middle of the park for Cray Valley there. Ball's a big threat when it goes into Lee Byrne. He's fresh, he's light on his feet, he just feels that he could make something happen, and from a defensive midfield perspective, it was good play from him.
As I was saying, the only time that Steve McKim got to this stage before as a manager is Tunbridge Angels side, were smashed 7-0 at home by Bradford City, but there's never been any danger of Cray Valley Paper Mills being beaten to a pulp today.
Dear me. Oh. I mean, it's a good game. I thought we'd seen the end of them terrible paper jokes.
Papering over the cracks. Smashed away by Freeman. Ness. Thomas. They looked like they were putting the Millers under the pump late on, but Charlton move. Just lost their way a little. I think that might say what the Millers are content with at the moment. Bit of a Havitt style clearance from Lee. And they'll certainly have it if it stays like this. Be some atmosphere at the Arctic Stadium for the replay if they take it to one.
Could be a chilly reception, couldn't it?
Saying nothing. Here's Anau, and still firm but fair. Charlton on the move again. Fraser, Tedic. Well, it's a tricky one. Not the most convincing header. May's there. I didn't say credit to the Millers for keeping May quiet, but they might have other problems here. Pindle in the area, and a smart save. Lee Byrne's effort skidded towards goal and Freeman got down sharply.
Well, I think the shot was on there, maybe. Comes inside and it's really good improvisation from Lee Byrne. He just wants to get this on target and he does that job. He swivels. It's tough to hit that on the floor. But everything that has been thrown at Freeman, he's dealt with. I have to say, his handling, that one-on-one in the first half. And in the second half, actually, he came out with a great block. I think it was Kirk, wasn't it? 1v1. He's had a good game, the goalkeeper.
Asimwe. Lee Byrne lets it go. May. Back for Lee Byrne. They've worked that well. Oh, and Lee Byrne went over. Referee played on, and now the free kick goes the Millers' way.
It did look a foul to me on Lee Byrne, maybe. He's certainly not happy. Well, player of the match. It's pretty simple for me in terms of a player that has been all over this pitch all game. And it goes to Sonny Black, the number 8 of Cray Valley. I think he's been brilliant, both in and out of possession. I mean, you could name maybe any of them, to be honest. Williams at right back's been superb. Lee at centre back. Ibrahim, the quality of the pass for Lisby in the goal was great. But for me, Sonny Black, just across everything, has been in the right place at the right time. He's my man of the match.
He was the manager's player of the year last season as well. Ness. Thomas. Watson. It's a bit pedestrian and a bit static from Charlton Athletic now. There is a wall of green between them and Sam Freeman's goal mind. A proper defence against attack at the moment. 2.5 minutes of the 10 additional remaining. Ness. Watson. Fraser. Plenty of red in there to try and aim for. Does it come to Lieber? And it went all the way across, and Simway couldn't hook it back in.
It'd just be heartbreaking, wouldn't it, for Cray Valley if they conceded at this stage, 97th minute. But again, all those green shirts locked in with red shirts, everybody doing their job, not allowing a free space or a free header in the box. He's got to be so pleased with his team's discipline.
Just over 90 seconds of additional time left to play. Coombs going up. That might come the way of Coombs. And still, Coombs, the pass was on. Ademilui! Still has it. First time ball in is useful. Oof, nearly came for Gale.
I don't know who it was arriving in the box, but there was a pass from Coombs on in the opposite direction. If you just saw it.
Coombs tries to flick that one on. Last minute of stoppage time. Ibrahim. Cracking cut tie and a brilliant effort.
It's been a great watch, isn't it?
Yeah. Apart from for him, I guess.
Yeah, maybe not. Still, he would have learnt about a lot about the players on the pitch who he started. You know, it's a challenge for these players. It's not easy.
Lieben touches it on. There might still be late heartbreak for the non-league side here. Tedic opens up a bit for him here. Anderson. Caroy Anderson. Fraser. Great defending by Gale. Now the away fans want the final whistle. Charlton maybe with one last chance to snatch the win. Fraser back across, and Lieburn couldn't convert.
Well, who is that man in the box stuck to Lieburn like glue? It's Lee again. Brilliant defending from the centre back.
Lee's still down. Charlton aren't going to put the ball out. He needs to get up and try and defend. Fraser loops it back in. Should be the keeper's. He didn't call it though. Valley, for Valley, they have come to the home of the former winners and held them to a draw. Five leagues and 117 places between the two clubs, but the work from Kyrol Lisby, son of Kevin, forced the own goal from Lucas Ness. That means that they are still in the cup and they will take their League One opponents to a replay. A cracking effort from Steve McKim's men, and they are very good value for their draw.
I mean, what a great performance. I mean, if they wanted to empty the tank, they certainly did that, Cray Valley. Every player on that pitch gave everything they had. Such an impressive performance from them. The discipline, the teamwork they had to stick together. Big, big credit goes out to Cray Valley to still be in this competition. They're celebrating, and rightly so.
And I guess it all came down to whatever the words of wisdom were at half-time, because they were a different team after the break.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think there may have been a realisation almost that they were capable in this game of getting something from it. And they've proven that. But it was all about their attitude, their mentality coming out in the second half. Was absolutely brilliant, and it just made Taney cup tight.
Well, just look at those scenes. It feels like a win for them. It has ended in a draw. Charlton Athletic 1, Cray Valley Paper Mills 1.
Well, just magnificent. We've been to many of these FA Cup ties, but this is one of the best atmospheres. Look at that away end. Absolutely sensational. And we're delighted to say the Cray Valley manager, Steve McKim, is with us. We're going to do a very quick chat with you, Steve, and then you can run to the away end and celebrate. Thank you so much for joining us here. I mean, what a performance from your lads today.
I can't speak highly of the players. They were unbelievable. We knew we was up against it coming here for our hide hour up in the league. But when they bring the five big guns on at 1-1, you know you're up against it even more. And my players to a player was unbelievable. And to take them back to our place is fantastic.
This is incredible. What a fantastic performance. I mean, what did you say to them at half-time, Steve?
Just said believe in themselves. I believe if you put cross in the box, you're going to cause problems. And we put cross in the box and we caused problems. We could have even scored from one of the other crosses. But the problem being, if you don't take them chances against good opposition, they come back and hurt you.
Just look over Paul's shoulder. Look at that away end. Steve, how proud are you tonight? I mean, incredible stuff.
I'm going to be having plenty of Guinnesses tonight. Trust me.
Brilliant stuff. Fantastic, isn't it, Joby?
Yeah, absolutely incredible. We said at half-time, maybe it just took 20 minutes for the players to believe that this was a stage they could come and perform. And once they did, we saw what happened, not just the end of the first half, but fantastic second half.
Well, I watched Bromley last night and they've done the same. And then when you give belief to players, they thrive on that. And like I said, we're on a hide in nothing today. But we're here to enjoy ourselves. And look at that, we're certainly enjoying ourselves.
All right, Steve, do you know what? We're going to let you go. Go and enjoy it. Thank you so much for joining us. And really good to you. Thank you very much, Lee. Go over there and enjoy it with your away fans. Absolutely sensational. I'm going to hand my microphone back there. I mean, Paul, this is the stuff of FA Cup dreams. This is what it's all about, right?
Unbelievable. Like we said, after 20 minutes, they believed they should be here. They come out second half, they put a ball in the box, got a goal, and they believed they went from strength to strength.
I'm delighted to say another guest has run over. Sonny Black, player of the match. Sonny, many congratulations. I mean, can you sum up the emotions?
Oh, thank you. No, I don't think there's any words that can sum that up. Well, that wasn't in our wildest dreams. That was just, it was amazing to come here and get a draw at the Valley.
What changed in the second half? Because you really grew in confidence, didn't you?
Yeah, the gaffer just said, you know, we played well in the first half. He said, go out in the second half and trust in yourselves. He said, stay in it and then you never know, anything can happen. They come a bit sooner than we expected, but that gave us the lift we needed to go on and get the draw.
Yeah, what about that chance he had in the second half?
Oh, it fell to me and the other players slipped.
Is that what happened? Because the boy said, as we were watching the game, the boy said, I think this is what happened. Basically, you've just been a bit shocked by the slip.
Yeah, I just didn't expect it and it's come. I probably should have swung at it with my right and I've ended up going with my left, so... Yeah, I was gutted.
Jace, I can't believe you've asked him that. He's covered every blade of grass on that pitch tonight. It was absolutely fantastic.
It's because we had it lined up, that's why.
He's saving for the winner for the replay, I think.
Exactly.
No, honestly, great effort. So tough in there in terms of the off-the-ball work that you guys had to do. And I think once you got a grasp on the game and you started keeping the ball a little bit better, we saw what you guys could go and do in that game.
Yeah, definitely. They had a little rotation over their right side in the first half, which we struggled with for the first 10-15 minutes. But I think once we got to grips with it, we was compact and it was hard to break down.
Yeah, we were saying that in the first half. You just needed to get up the pitch and just have possession of the football for about 20 minutes.
Yeah, definitely. There was times even I was caught probably in the back line. I probably should have been a little bit higher. But yeah, I think second half we went out and executed it well.
Sonny, can I just ask you about the fans? I mean, terrific support.
I mean, absolutely amazing. You know, normally at our home games we only get about 150. So, you know, the fact they've all come out today is amazing. And hopefully when we get back home, we can get them back in as well.
So, your place next. You must fancy it. Replay?
Pardon?
The replay, you must fancy it at your place.
Back at our turf, yeah. Definitely. This has given us all the confidence we need to go into that game.
The games are stacking up though, aren't they?
Yeah, we've got quite a lot of games in hand in the league, but, you know, from the beginning of the season, we've been taking it one game at a time, so we'll keep doing that.
Right, Sonny, top man, I'll take your microphone. I'll say thank you very much indeed. Well done today, you were brilliant today. Fantastic. Go and enjoy the celebrations. Absolutely wonderful. Great. Well, let's look at that second half performance, because Joby, as I said to Sonny there, they grew in confidence and just had the feeling they could cause some sort of upset tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, the manager needs to take an awful amount of credit for giving them that belief and saying, look, we have to go and put them under situations that they have to defend. Ibrahim does brilliant there. And then this is a brilliant pass outside of the boot. Lisby, who we spoke about so much, will be so happy that he contributed in this manner. But you can see the strength, the energy. I think this is a great clip just to show what work they did in that midfield. We just throw it to Sonny Black and Ibrahim. Again, real bit of quality to get in behind. And a ball that, no matter what level you're playing at, they're horrible to deal with, aren't they?
Especially as a defender, you don't want to be defending balls behind you, which he's defending the ball behind him, tries to clear it, ends up in his own goal. But fair play. And Lisby there.
And also, there's an angle there when Kyra Lisby puts that ball in and the ball has gone into the back of the net. As soon as he's delivered the ball, he knows, he's almost started his celebration. He knows where that ball's going.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's what you want to do, you know, when you're getting down the outside of people and just put things across that area, because it is so difficult. Defenders have to then make decisions, and we see that happen. And particularly when you're not playing regularly, we spoke about that. You know, there's a much changed back line. Put them under pressure, make them defend situations, and they get the benefits from that.
Disappointing for Kyra Lisby, you know, we talked about his dad and Kevin at half time and just how proud he was, and he was absolutely distraught when he picked up that injury, Joe.
He was, and again, we did touch on it. I think when you're coming into a game that meant so much to him, there's so many emotions, you're trying to suppress them and concentrate on the game. And I think this was just a moment where all those emotions came out. You could see he's devastated. But listen, he's played a big part tonight in the reason that Cray Valley have got a result, and hopefully it's nothing too serious and they can get him back out there soon.
Yeah, I've just been told that, I know we've been concentrating on chatting here, he's been out there celebrating, mind. So if it's a muscle injury, not stopped him running to the away end as well. But just in terms of their spirit today as well, Paul, that's what we have to praise them for today.
Yeah, and I think that's what gets you through, especially games like this. They're the underdogs, they come in, they have nothing to lose, and they give out their all, and they created chances left, right and centre tonight, and especially in the second half. And
here's that chance again.
They could go and win it right near the end here as well, like you know, Black.
I know you said and laughed, Joby, that we showed him it, but it was lined up, so we thought we'd give it a go. But tell you what, yes, he's one player of the match. He was terrific today, but again, they had a chance as well with Coombs.
Yeah, they finished the game really strongly, actually. And listen, they had to sit in at times, and we thought maybe that energy, the fact in terms of the level they're playing at the moment, not as fit probably as that Charlton Athletic team, but you certainly couldn't see it. I've got to say here, we're standing here, some Charlton fans, given this team, and rightfully so, a great reception.
Look at
here.
These pictures, Steve and his coaching team. Absolutely wonderful scenes. Well done to Cray Valley. They've been terrific. We should also talk about their defence as well. Just how well they defended, especially in those last 10 minutes.
Yeah, for sure. I thought their shape was really good, nice and compact. I thought they dealt with balls coming into the box really, really well. Williams in particular, the right back, really good positionally. Every time the ball was coming in, he was having a look over his shoulder, making sure he was dealing with situations. And again, they saw it out in the end, I'd say, fairly comfortably.
Just behind us as well, great to see some Charlton Athletic fans have been applauding Cray Valley as well. Let's talk about Charlton, because if Michael Appleton doesn't make those changes, do you think they win this tie tonight?
Yeah, I do. I think 11 changes is a lot to make, especially in an FA Cup game when you expect you to win. Making 11 changes is a big call, and it proved today.
We see it so often, don't we? So many managers, Joby, up and down the leagues, they look at it and think, right, you know, we've got an away game at Portsmouth on Saturday, that's more important than the FA Cup, and then you come unstuck.
You do, but I'm sure Michael Appleton will be thinking that 11 that he put out should be able to come and get a result. But for us that have played in it, it does affect your rhythm sometimes. They weren't very fluid, and I think that is a result of having that many changes.
But Charlton did have their chances, didn't they?
Yeah, they did, and I think that's the point I was making. I still feel he will think that they had enough. I mean, this great through ball, Kurt gets onto it, but again, you know, another player really stood up today, the keeper. And again here, you know, balls from wide positions and looked like it was just about to loop over and just touches the top of the crossbar there.
Yeah. So they had their chances, didn't they? But I tell you what, did you hear the boos as well, Paul, from the Charlton Athletic fans?
Yeah, I did in the final whistle then. Yeah. And they weren't happy when some stick as I was going back down, which probably is expected because they expected to beat Cray five leagues below him. So
yeah, Miles Leeburn made a bit of a difference when he came on, didn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had a real good presence in that attacking area. He's a player who's got so much ability.
And look at this, last minute. Look at the defending.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
There's a body
there.
He's
got to get up after that either.
No, exactly. He was cramping up the whole in the second half.
But fantastic.
That's what you need to do. Again, don't let them get free opportunities in the box. And to a man, they were exceptional tonight.
What are you doing the week after next? Fancy the replay?
For sure, yeah. Can't wait for it.
It's going to be a great night out, isn't it? And they'll fancy it, won't they, Joby?
Absolutely, particularly with that crowd that we saw tonight. They'll be coming in. It'll be a packed house. And we've seen today they can cause problems. They're magnificent.
Have you enjoyed it, Joby?
Brilliant, brilliant cup time.
It's been great having you. Paul?
Yeah, loved it. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Really good to see you. So many congratulations to Cray Valley Paper Mills. They have delivered one of the scorelines of the FA Cup first round proper. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.
Down in the depths of this valley of mine, I hold out for hope just enough to get by. I look at the stars and see how they light up the sky. Some days it feels like a mountain to climb. Go up and go down, it's a white knuckle ride. There are twists and it turns, I'm leaving this valley.